Hi guys, this is Chris with Recombu, and we're here with the new Lumia 950 and 950 XL, Microsoft's two latest flagship phones. Spot the difference here, the box is obviously very, very similar, because Microsoft has gone for a consistent look and feel across all of its Windows 10 devices, basically. So these are the first two official Windows 10 phones from Microsoft. And yeah, the whole design, the whole ethos of Windows 10 is the fact that you've got your phone, your Windows phone, you're playing with your apps and everything, and then you get back home, and the look and feel of Windows 10 on your desktops, your laptops, whatever, is exactly the same. So let's have a crack open at the boxes anyway and see what's inside. So we'll start with the Lumia 950. So as you can see, quite a nice chunky box there. No expense spared. Let's see if we can get this bad boy open. Yeah! Right, so here's our first look at the Lumia 950. Let's just get it out of its little plastic wrapping. So as you can see, we've got an all-black model here. Let's see if it's got any power and we can get it booting up while we actually take a look. Yep, just felt a little rumble there. There we go, so that is booting up. So, Lumia 950. It's, you know, nicely sort of little chunky phone, like most of Microsoft's Lumias, quite chunky. But it feels quite nice, it's got a nice little heft to it. It certainly feels like a premium phone, which this is, of course, retailing at 419. So if you have a bit of a look around, you see it's got a nice glossy front, got the Microsoft logo up at the top there. On the side, you've got usual power, volume, and actual physical camera button, which is always nice. Down below, hopefully you can see this, we've got a Type-C USB connector. So that'll be very good for not only doing fast charge, but also for using Windows' own Continuum feature, which we'll chat about quickly later. Up top, we've got an earphone port. And then around the back, we've got the Windows logo. And that says PureView Zeiss, so that's referring to 20 megapixel camera here. It's a Carl Zeiss Optics 20 megapixels, same with across both phones. And you've got a triple LED flash, which I was blinded with in the briefing. I can definitely assure you that is nice and powerful. So if we jump in this, let's start setting it up. So English United Kingdom, yeah, that is correct, not Jamaican. United Kingdom. SIM error, that's because I haven't actually stuck my SIM in yet, sorry about that. Right, so date and time, yep, that's all fine. What time is it now? Not 5 o'clock, but yeah, we are in London time, so hopefully it'll register that. And now we're gonna do all the connecting to Wi-Fi and everything. Okay, so we're now connected to the Wi-Fi. Let's skip ahead again. Express, yep, let's do this super quick, just to zoom through it all. And then of course, this is where you can sign in with your Microsoft account. So once again, let's skip ahead. Woo! Okay, so while my Microsoft account's signing in, let's just have a quick look at the rest of the box. There's always some super exciting shit in here. So, hey, Microsoft product and safety info, that'll be a nice bit of bedtime reading. Otherwise, in this half, hopefully got the Type-C charging cable. Yep, there we go, nice bit of Type-C action. And got the UK charger and everything as well. So that's all good. Excellent. There you go, told you it would be thrilling. You know, if you're gonna watch an unboxing video, you've gotta expect to see somebody rifling through a box, right? Okay, so there we go. So now we can choose to restore an old phone. As you can see, we've had quite a few Windows phones in the office recently. So let's just, can we just not bother? Yeah, let's not bother with doing all that. OneDrive, yeah, sure, that's fine. Yeah, OneDrive, I think you get, what was it, like 5 gigs free OneDrive space now. Cortana, super assistant. She is super, of course, if you used Cortana before. She's one of our favorite voice assistants. Very handy, very good notifications, alerts, all that kind of stuff. So, okay, so it's doing installation now. We'll just quickly, while that's setting up, rip open the 950 XL and give you a look at that. So I'm assuming this side of the box is all exactly the same as before. Here's the actual 950 XL phone. So yeah, might be getting a sense of deja vu right about now. Ah, go away. As you can see, looks pretty similar to the 950 in most respects. It's obviously a bigger size. So this is a 5.7 incher, whereas the original 950 is 5.2 inches. So there's a 0.5 difference in the screen size, which as you can see makes quite a significant difference in terms of height. In terms of weight, they actually feel quite similar. It doesn't feel much heavier than 950 XL, so that's nice. And in terms of general size, well, I've got the Xperia Z5 Premium on me here. So as you can see, shaping up, it's pretty much identical in terms of dimensions and everything there. And more or less the same in terms of weight as well. Certainly in the hand, it feels more or less the same. So we can get that booting up as well. So yeah, it's got funky different buttons on the side as well. So as you can see, we've got three close-by buttons here. Different layout to the 950. But in terms of actual differences between the phones themselves, other than the obvious screen size, there's not a whole lot. This is rocking a Snapdragon 810, the 950 XL is, whereas the smaller 950 is rocking a Snapdragon 808, so you've got hexa-core versus octa-core. To be honest, in our tests, we've noticed very little difference between the two chipsets. It's all good. So we've got the same 20 megapixel camera on the back. You'll see that on the XL, it actually juts out quite a bit further. It's got a different design. So you've got the flash actually built into the bit that sticks out there, and the lens and everything. But apart from that, very similar design. It's once again Type-C here on the bottom. Let's just take that all off. So yeah, so very similar in terms of the hardware and in terms of the features. It once again supports Microsoft's Continuum feature and all the rest. And as you can see, the user experience should be basically exactly the same. So what else is there to say? Well, let's have a quick flick through. This is still installing stuff apparently, so can't show you the actual Windows desktop just yet. But yeah, in terms of the specs and everything, I think that's basically the main stuff covered off. As I say, Windows Continuum is supported on both phones. So you can basically, what that means is you can hook up to the Continuum dock, which is sold separately. I think it comes in at about £70 or £80. But that's going to be available at the launch date, first week in December, the same as these two phones here in the UK. So that's good news. And that basically allows you to hook up to any kind of monitor. It's got HDMI and DisplayPort. So that basically means you can hook up to any sort of TV or monitor you've got in your house, as long as it's not a proper clunky old SCART effort. So that's good news, and that basically allows you to perform all of your phone tasks on a big screen, but with a standard sort of Windows 10 desktop layout as opposed to the phone layout, because even though they are similar, obviously it's nicer on a big screen to have a bit more space to navigate around and do all that. So yeah, so this seems to be taking its sweet time getting everything installed for now. So what we'll do is we'll do a full review for you very, very shortly. And we'll be testing out the camera screens, everything else. If there's anything you want to know, just give us a shout in the comments down below. And we'll try our best to do full feature videos on everything, including Continuum and all the rest of the big features. Okay, cheers for watching, guys. Have a good one.